In this video, we will see how to hide sensitive data which is getting printed in the form of JSON or in the form of toString into our console, or if you are using rolling file appender. Now, if I scroll down a little bit, we will see a JSON formatted, output, and also a toString formatted output. And if you observe the product name and the seller name, the product name information and seller information are hidden. So how to achieve this kind of logs in the console or in the rolling file appender? Alright, so now that we understood about the acceptance criteria, now we will talk about how we are going to achieve this. For that, we just need to expand up to SRC main resources folder. And inside resources folder, we need to create a logback.xml file. Now the naming convention is very important. Either the file name should be logback.xml or the file name should be logging-spring.xml. Now before jumping into the logback.xml, we will understand about the exact function which we are going to use in the logback.xml. Yes, we are going to use a function which is called replace function, and that replace function will help us to achieve masking. Basically, the replace expression is written inside a pattern tag in the logback.xml. And before that, if we have to understand the syntax, then it is written like %replace followed by %message in the parenthesis. Basically, this message is nothing but, the individual log getting generated in the console, followed by a pair of curly brackets is needed, where the first expression will be our regular expression to figure out the secrets like the product name, seller name, etc. And followed by, we will use the output string. Basically, this string is going to replace the product name information and seller name value by using XXX multiple X values, right? So these things will be replaced. Let me recap. The first one is replace expression or replace function, followed by the log messages. So this will be dynamically injected as a parameter to replace function, followed by the regular expression and the string output. All right. So let's jump on to another part of the replace expression, which is nothing but multi-replace expression. So this will be a little bit tricky. So let's quickly see how multi-replace expression is going to be written. So exactly the syntax begins with %replace, followed by the upper replace expression is going to replace the message, and followed by regular expression and the output strings. Now, as I had mentioned, this replace function will be enclosed by a pattern tag, and this pattern tag is actually resided inside a console appender or a rolling file appender, along with some additional details, where %d represents the date, %thread represents the current thread which is executing during that moment, %level represents the log level, which is info, debug, trace, error, those log informations will be coming up, followed by the logger information in the sense, the fully qualified class name, and then %n represents the new line, and %ex represents the exceptions. And always remember, the entire expression you have mentioned inside the pattern tag should be written in a single line. It should not be multi-line. Just because of the space constraint, I have written in a multi-line. Now let's quickly jump into the logback.xml we have. So the first appender part is a console appender, as you can see, and console appender has a name, and this console appender name is added to the trace level. You can change it to info as well. And there is a rolling file appender also. And this rolling file appender also has a time and size based strategy. So maximum file size should be 5 MB. If the file size reaches to its threshold point, then automatically another file will be created. And the file name is also mentioned. As you can see, it is dynamic. So the first part is log path. Log path represents the directory where this rolling file is going to be created, followed by the file name. The file name is also dynamic. Log path and the file name is coming from the environment variable. Here in my application, I will show you where I have configured. So I'll click on the run and go to edit configuration. And here I have configured the environment variable. So let me see if this test app log folder is there or not. Otherwise, I will create a new one. Alright, so test app log has been created by the Spring Boot application. When it started, it created on its own. So as of now, we have not yet added any masking. So without masking, how the output is coming, let me show you first. So I'm inserting list of product details. Now if I click send, I'm getting 200 success response. And now when I execute get product endpoint, I'm getting those two inserted, newly inserted records. Let's quickly check the logs. Okay, without masking, product name and the seller name is coming in the console log. even if I print in the JSON format or if I print in the toString format. Let me quickly show you how am I printing. For that, I have to go inside the product controller, and product controller has a get products endpoint where I've just used object mapper value as string function, which is accepting list of product response, and it is further generating the JSON response here, and followed by products dot toString. This toString is working because in the product response I have added Lombok provided toString. Now a quick tip: before writing anything into the logback XML, we will test how the replace function is going to work along with the regular expression. So to do that, I'll copy this JSON and I'll go to regex101.com. This is a very useful website when we are going to test any regular expression. So I'll just paste it out in the JSON file in the test string area. And of course, in the top input box represents the input box for regular expression. I already have worked on the regular expression before, so I have already written it. Now, in place of your string, you just have to mention product name. Now, if you find out the exact string by the regular expression from the test string, then your matching output will come here. Now, I click on substitution. In the substitution, you have to mention exactly what string is going to replace this product name, which is found due to this regular expression. So, I'll add $1. Which means whatever the thing has been found out before colon will be replaced as it is. And then I'll mention double inverted comma, then XXX. Now, if you see the output, the product name is coming with XXX value. So the entire expression we have to use in the replace function, and this entire substitution also we have to mention in the replace function as well. Let me show you quickly how it is to be done. We also have another thing, which is toString generated logs. So we have to mask toString generated logs as well. So for that, I'll copy the toString message and paste it in the regular expression here only once. And you just have to mention your the desired string that you are going to figure out, seller name. Here the slash b is very important, guys. The advantage of slash b is the string you are writing inside the slash b a case insensitive. Suppose if I change the seller name to something name, a is uppercase, then it is still finding out. Let me add the substitution seller name equal to, as I had mentioned last time, we have a message and this message has to be replaced. This message has to be enclosed by a parenthesis provided by the replace function. The first argument inside the curly bracket will be the regular expression. So I will go inside the browser, and for JSON masking, I'll copy the regular expression here, product name. And I think the second part was the substitution, which is $1, then double inverted comma, and then bunch of X values, or maybe the star values you can add. Now, to deal with multiple masking, we have to use replace function multiple times. So I'll cut this entire expression. I'll put a replace function, but instead of message, dollar message, I'll paste the entire expression, and after the parenthesis, I'll put the curly bracket, again the comma. Why did I use the second replace function? Just because we not only have to mask the product name coming in the JSON, also we need to mask the product name coming in the toString method. So for that, I'll copy a regular expression to mask the product name coming in toString. Alright, so now this entire replace expression again I'll copy, and again I'll write down replace function. This replace function will be for the seller detail masking, right? So again, instead of message, I'll copy the entire replace function. And for seller details, again, I'll copy the JSON expression, sorry, the regular expression to mask the JSON. Instead of product name, I'll mention here seller name. And this, since this is a JSON based masking, so I'll use $1, and then I will copy the entire expression again. And finally, we have last one thing, seller name coming in the toString method. So again, I'll mention percentage replace. Be careful for the parentheses, commas and all. And then I'll copy the expression for toString and paste it here. Seller name, which is fine. seller name equal to. Alright, so I forgot to mention this pattern in the rolling file appender. I just added in the console appender. So I'll add it to the rolling file appender and then we will test both the output together. So inside encoder, we have to add the pattern tag and the pattern tag will contain the entire structure. So we'll restart the application and test it again. In the postman, we will insert the record first. Yet again, I'm using the same payload, so it will be very simple. So now, after executing the get request, which is working absolutely fine, let's quickly jump into the console log. Now, if you see, the product name and the seller name is coming with star values. And the seller name in the two string value is also coming as expected. Let's see how the messages are coming in rolling file appender. So I'll go to the rolling file appender based directory and then I'll open it in the text editor. Now if I scroll down, all the log details are also coming in a hidden way. So that's it for the video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for more videos.